WJBW is made possible by sausage. Stick one in your mouth.
Hey, all you racists out there, you should not be listening to our show because we do not like you. JB Retro.
Next.
Bob Leamy is the one guy that I know that has a drill bit big enough to do a big, nice glory hole at any drug stop he goes to.
You're very silly. You know that. A silly man.
Nope. Fastest man to woman. That's what we're going to do. Yeah.
Sometimes I don't listen to some of our podcasts.
Very flat.
That's where it's at.
Yeah, I like it.
Oh, you know, some people are into that. I know there's a website.
Fucking asinine.
Some shit like some that. Shit you gotta like do the Rocky Mountain Ride. Big
Disco.
Oh, that is good. Always live, always original. It is the JB Rep Show. I am JB Webb. Reverend is running a little bit late, and I got Jack DeMarco, however. DeMarco right over there. What? Oh, I forgot what channel you were on.
My mic, hello?
I was turning
here?
The Rev's mic up. I'm so sorry.
What?
Anyway, welcome to it. This is our hashtag good juju edition. We got Katie McKinley of Kinky Katie Radio. That's going to be a fun session right out of the gate, 7:30. 8 o'clock hour, our Beth's Burgers. Beth got sick, so we're not going to be doing that. And that's the point. Show must always go on.
That's a bummer. I was really looking forward to talking to her. I really like me some Beth Burgers.
I love some Beth Burgers.
Oh, yeah, yeah, so yeah. We'll their fries were real good, too.
Yeah, we'll talk a little bit about that, what we know. And then 8:30 hour, maybe if he can call in a little early, it's Austin Vanderbleek from down south. Guy's a really talented DJ. I love his stuff. I met him a long time ago at a Frankie Knuckles thing here in Orlando. And he's a younger guy, but he's got some chops. So we'll be excited. He does Open House Conspiracy. We're going to talk with him a little bit. And then, of course, our tried and true Breaking News Badly and Reverend's Revelation. I presume the Reverend will be trickling in here any minute or so. We figured we're going to go ahead and fire this baby up. Because right out of the gate, you know, we get some flack. I've been doing this 10 years. This is our 10th season. But for whatever reason, the math is always, it's only 9. So anyway, we're just saying, you know what? Sometimes you got to do whatever you can do to keep going forward. And that is definitely what we are all about over here. We do everything live. We try to really keep everything original. And this year, we've had Jack DeMarco join us and John Jennings is joining us as well.
Oh, yeah,
well.
No new movies this week, huh?
No movies this week.
Nothing good coming out to review.
Well, we did that twice in a row. But anyway, we kind of proved the last couple of weeks that we can do, things without your phone calls. So watch out.
Call in because, you know, we want to hear from you.
Yeah, and also,
if you're out there live and listening, what?
Okay,
the bag is packed.
Sitting in studio, return guest, the plastic bag from American Beauty. Now it's got a Publix logo on it. Oh, things go bad at Target. Now he's at Publix. Okay, it's rough for our friend. He's the most popular, famous guest we've ever had. Been in American Beauty.
Maybe we'll get into that story about Target.
No, we don't want to hear it, bag. Just
later,
go.
Maybe later,
yeah, maybe
bag.
Maybe later, bag.
We got other things we need to take care of.
We got a little bit of an agenda here.
Stay in your corner for the moment. You stay in your lane, bag.
Yeah, stay in your lane, bag. Thank you, Jack. In the background, you're listening to Wolfpack.
Wolfpack.
You ever hear of these guys?
I have not. Sorry.
I love bands like that, like Fat Night. I just love the original stuff. Because we do original music every week under the Circadian Cast banner, the CC for short, we play people's original music. So you can send us stuff. You can go to our website, comment, do whatever you want to do. We're all about trying to give you a little bit of love and attention each and every week.
It's
plus,
groovy.
This season, you know, well, thank you. And thank you, Wolfpack. This season, we are really trying to go a little bit more centric to topics and opening up discussion, being a proponent of, opening up dialogues. So on this first edition here, this good juju, hold on, I want to be able to send this out, yes. And I found a topic that I wanted to start the show with before we get the call. with Katie, and it's called shadow banning. You ever hear of shadow banning?
I not until you right. told me that we're going to talk about it. Yeah. So I looked it up, and it's pretty.
It's interesting.
It's wild.
So you never really know. And apparently it's been going on for quite a little while. So shadow banning, as it's defined by the Google search here I did, shadow banning, also called stealth banning, ghost banning, or comment ghosting, is the act of blocking or partially blocking a user, so that's you and I, users of social media, or their content. So, or our content from an online community. So if you're, and then I'll finish it up. So it says such that it will not be readily apparent to the user that they have been banned. So I put out a post, nobody likes it. That could be that that post has been shadow banned. Not necessarily me, the post.
By Facebook, Instagram, or Instagram,
social
or
media, Twitter, whatever. I think they're all doing it.
I'm sure they are.
I think they're all doing it. So the interesting thing is now your platform that you said, here, I can go ahead and talk with people and get my voice out there, is not letting me get my voice out there.
Right.
You're cock blocking me. You're censoring me, right? That's basically what I call shadow banning is we're being censored.
I mean, it's really interesting. You know, with Facebook is allowing right now, they're allowing like political ads.
Yeah.
You know, like that.
They make a lot of money doing that.
Yeah, then they're allowing, but like the whole controversy is that if a politician puts a political ad on there, even if they're giving false information,
yeah,
Facebook is not going to censor that.
Okay.
Right. So Facebook is, because I guess they're not in the job of fact checking. I mean,
well, that's horrible then.
You know,
I think that's how we got into this whole mess with Trump in the beginning. But Trump. Disinformation.
Did you see that they booed him at the World Series?
I did see that.
I saw this like crazy article that somebody on some, you know, faux news channel, let's say. The faux news
channel.
Is
it real news or are you just saying instead of fake, faux?
I'm saying like instead of Fox News.
Oh, I love
like
faux walls. You ever see the faux walls
where
they look like, you know, it's old kind of plaster, Italian, Venetian.
So that somebody tried to spin the chant. Like, you know, some people, you know, there were a lot of boos. I don't know if anyone hasn't seen it.
Right.
You know, just game five of the World Series. During the third inning, they were giving a salute to the troops. Everyone was cheering. They announced the president. Everyone started booing.
Yeah.
And in some areas, some people started chanting, lock him up, lock him up.
Yeah, I heard that.
You know, off of the whole up chant that
a banner that said veterans for impeachment.
Right behind home plate after that. Right behind home plate. And then there was another impeached Trump that like hung from higher up and like, it was crazy. So somebody tried to spin that the lock him up chant was that like the fans were chanting lock him up for 4 more years as president.
Oh my God.
Are you kidding me? How?
That's not what that means.
Like that is like, this is like 1984. Like,
you know,
this, like we were talking about books last week, right? Like 1984 was a book that I had to read in high school. So like, I mean, and I'm not going to say the exact line, but because I don't remember it. But, you know, like at the end of that book, it's like the party is telling you not to believe what's in front of your eyes. I mean, that's what is happening right now. They're like, they're literally saying, no, this isn't happening. Like, don't believe the 4-star generals and the people who've sacrificed their lives for our country. Believe this reality star. Failed businessman, man, New York shyster.
Subplot. It's not the real plot, it's the subplot. It's not the real news, it's the fake news.
It's crazy.
You know, it reminded me a lot of Roman gladiator shit. You know what I mean? you ever see Gladiator, the movie? That's a great movie.
I've never seen that kind of stuff.
But that reminded me of...
I'm kidding. Like 1,000 times.
Okay.
I could probably recite the whole movie for you. Like start to finish right now.
I've seen it a ton of times too. I love it. And the point of that is, remember at the end there where the emperor, you know, is facing off with him and has to fight him?
Yeah.
And he tries to... Anyway, so... And then the crowd turns...
It's
like, no, you know, we think you're wrong. I don't know. I just, you know, this unfortunately, I think is going to go down in a public square, a public space like that. Anyway, but maybe we'll be shadow banned from it, right? maybe
they're listening right now and they're like debating this Jack DeMarco character and this JB Webb character. Shall we start shadow banning them from from their message? Well, their message needs to be squashed.
Last week we spoke a little bit about the Spreaker and the changes over there. Remember that real briefly? They're changing some of the ways that they count their listens. So anonymous listens no longer.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Yeah, so you got to be logged in as a user. So that kind of, you know, has a negative effect, I think, on my show. If I have 20 listens and 20 downloads, but it's only showing 5 listens and seven downloads.
Yeah.
It's kind of hurting me as a
People don't want to log into things. Sometimes they just want to, like, you know, be like, oh, look, my friend's doing a thing. I want to click on and listen to it, but they don't want to log in.
But that shit should always count.
Of course,
a listen is a listen. Anyway, a listen is a listen. And that's what,
right.
There you go. And we do all this for the love. We make sure that we're talking with talented people. Now, real quick.
For the love, baby. For the love.
Before we get Katie in here and the Rev Busts in the room, I do want to say I love Beth's Burgers. If you've never been there, we encourage you to go. It's Beth's Burgers Bar, Beth's Burger Bar, and Lake Mary. Where's the other one? Hold on. Let me bring up the site.
Well, there used to be one downtown. That's the one I used to roll at.
Yeah, they had to. They got rid of that one. I don't think it was, you know, that downtown. It's tricky downtown.
It's just because it was tough to park. Like, you couldn't just, like, roll. You either needed to, like, park away or pay for parking or Uber.
And then you're like, I got to pay. I got to struggle to get in here. And So they're out at Lake K Universal Boulevard. That's 9938 Universal Boulevard. And then they're out at Lake Mary, 223 Wheelhouse Lane. And then the favorite spot, the one I love, is right up there in Edgewood. That is 5145 South Orange Ave. So, you know, like when you're taking Orange into, you know, Greater Orlando, where you're going down the
like, what's a cross street?
Like, you know, Kaylee, the next one down? Gore.
Yeah.
The next one down. So you go down, you know, a little bit further, and it's on the left hand side. It's technically Edgewood.
Okay.
Orange Avenue.
Past Delaney.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Past Soto.
Right.
Like Michigan.
You're going south, I guess. Yeah, you're going south on Orange. Anyway, so go check them out. Their full menu is there. It's bethsburgerbar.com. So she won't be able to join us. Maybe some future show she'll be able to join us.
And you get free cups.
But this is the point. Last minute cancellation, we're not going to bash her. Why would we bash her? You know, she's unfortunately sick, and she has done this to me before, Charlie Brown.
Called out sick?
Yep.
Called out sick?
Not called out sick, but couldn't do it. Committed and then couldn't do it. So in all the excitement, I guess here comes the Reverend. Let's make sure we got our call on time.
He's got to take care of some business first.
Okay. Wow! Close that door. Jeez! What a moron. Okay, shut up. Anyway, so we're expecting a call from Katie McKinley here any second, and you know, this young lady has been around in Orlando for quite a while. I think it's Kinky Katie Radio. And she's worked on a lot of shows, kinkykatieradio.com. And she's worked on a lot of shows over the years. And she has her own show, you know. It's kinkykatieradio.com. There we go. Thank you so much. So go to that site. Check that out. It's a little bit risque, you know. And you can subscribe. They do shows. You can listen on demand. I believe they do live shows. So I believe that's an adult site now that I'm looking at it. So, at any rate, hopefully we'll be able to chat with her. The Reverend's, making his way into studio here. Let's turn down his microphone. And, you ever hear of shadow banning the Rev? No.
What?
You ever hear of shadow ban? Oh yeah. What's up, buddy? Isn't that a cool photograph? Oh, great. It really is. It looks like a painting. Oh my God. Wow. Remarkable. We'll post this online. It's beautiful. You look awesome, dude.
Oh, look at that.
You both do. You and your lovely wife.
My lovely bride.
All right. So, thanks for coming in here. You're going to hang it up in the studio? You're taking that home with you. Okay.
I'm taking it home with me.
Of course you are.
Are we on live?
Yeah.
We're always live.
On the air?
We're live on the air, brother, man. We open the show.
Give me a hit of that mouth, bro.
Okay. Come on, man. Jesus. We're on the show. We started live. It's not nothing. We're expecting a call. Hello. We're expecting a call from Katie. I just want things to go as they're planned. Anyway, Beth Burgers.
Things never go as they're planned. Yeah. What kind of?
She.
Beth Burgers should not be allowed back on the show anymore.
Yeah, is that what you think, Reverend? Welcome to the show.
Well, thank you.
There we go.
We've been trying to get Beth Burgers.
Yeah, it's twice that kind of this has happened.
No, it's one more.
There
than
is
twice.
No on button there.
So, is my microphone on or my headphones?
Oh,
not
your
on?
Headphones are down. Hold on.
Okay. So, yeah. Oh, there we go.
So
yeah, whatever with Beth and her burgers.
Well, we're not going to bash anybody.
We're not going to invite her back on.
We just
anymore.
Spoke good about her. Yeah, if she can't, I'm not going to try to kick the Charlie Brown football anymore.
But seriously, we've been trying to make that happen for like 6 months.
Years. But that
years even, you're right.
Yeah, that kind of goes to the fact, you know, before
still
the show.
Still got good burgers,
and
though.
How about some whiskey, my friend?
Before the show, Jack and I were talking a little bit about the fact that, you know, we're a 10-year-old podcast. We're kind of we've done a lot of things first, we've made a lot of mistakes, we've corrected them, we've learned a lot, and you know, so for us to take a hit, if Katie doesn't call in either, guess what, it's not going to stop us.
No,
the show will always go on.
That's right,
here at the JD
the show must always go on.
If these people want to represent themselves in the world, like committing to something and then backing out, I understand Beth was sick, but again, this was a second time. So
and did she call out just today?
Yeah,
so that's bullshit, too. It's like, you know, if you make a hair appointment, you know, you don't call the day of to cancel. You need to give them 24 hours because let me tell you something. It's not, you know, you're like, you know, I'm just not feeling good or whatever. You know, my wife, my beautiful bride, happens to cut hair. And if you don't make an appointment, well, you know, especially for my bride, because she's filled out, you know, 2 weeks in. And coming into the holiday seasons, which we are now, Jack, it's like more like 3 weeks out.
Right.
So, you know, for her, especially if you're coming in for a cut and color that normally takes 2 to 3 hours and you cancel the day of, well, I mean, she's going to charge you a little bit. But, I mean, that fucks up her whole day.
Sure.
And, you know, she could have definitely filled that in, and it costs them money.
Yeah.
So, you know, I mean, not that we're making any money, a little more than that, JB.
You know, I've definitely worked for some TV shows in my career. And you know, it's a tough thing to put, right? Cause you plan your show around these things, right? So like when that happens, when somebody cancels on you, you have to last minute adjust the order of your show. And then, you know, you know, let's say if it was a short segment, even like a 5-10 minute segment, that's another 5 or 10 minute segments that you have to fill.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? That you got to be totally, like, all right, now I got to figure out what
ridiculous.
I'm going to put there.
Like, why do we waste all this time confirming this shit?
Yeah.
And you said yes. Anyway, it's kind of like that in the world today. So, you know, if you think you're funny, whatever it is, if you think it's sick, whatever it is, we don't fucking care. We're just trying to help promote what you're doing out there in the world.
Yeah.
And if you don't get it, you don't get it. There's a shit ton of people here in Orlando that do not get what the fuck we do. It's philanthropic. It's a fucking altruistic. And quite frankly, you know, if you don't see it as that, you can fucking suck a dick. Because I don't fucking care anymore. This is season apocalypse.
But I don't
season
suck dick.
10, motherfucker. Well, you will. You will be sucking dick, Reverend.
And so what if I do suck dick?
All right. So whatever you do, who cares? That's what
right,
we're
right, exactly.
We well, want to promote.
What I'm saying is...
Okay, yeah, say it while you're coughing. That'd be great. Great fucking radio.
I'll have you step
in. What's the matter with you?
Dude, I've kind of been sick all week.
Really, that's terrible.
Well, let me cut your mic then. Are you okay now? No, you asshole.
All right, I'm all right.
Oh, it's so funny. All right, so we're not talking with Katie McKinley.
We're not.
Apparently. She's not calling. It's 7:37.
I mean, do you have her number? Shoot her a text.
Yeah. I was kind of surprised that she's going to be on here.
You know, people talk to people and they think it's funny. You know, I think she's friends with some of the people. Because when you look back at my history, I started the show in 2010. It was on YouTube. I got on Blip, got a monetization deal. It was going great. I was syndicated and then got shut off because I covered Nude Night and showed naked bodies.
Hey, who's this and Austin then, Van Derber, Blake?
Shut up. And then after that, my show fucking died in 2013. I fucking got it back together, resurrected it. I lost my distribution. So I've already been through hell. You can't put me through any worse hell than I've already been with this show. I've already fucking done.
You're saying it's a personal vendetta?
No, no, no. I'm just saying, whatever the fuck they do, it doesn't hurt me because I've already been through so much shit with this show, spent so much money and time, made so many mistakes, had to learn how to recreate and resurrect my show. So in 2014, I got to do this show with Bubba Whoop-Ass Wilson called Grits and Gravy, and we did that right out of this room. We had a lot of cool people in here, but eventually he fell off. So there's just some motherfuckers out there in the world that
Whatever happened to that dude?
Their, I don't care.
He's on the Shannon Burke show now.
He can suck a dick, too. Who fucking cares?
Who?
I'm serious. Shannon Burke can suck a dick.
I thought Shannon Burke like, went
Rollins
to jail.
Russ Rollins can suck a dick. Fucking,
what's going on
what's
with you?
John Watson, are we in a time warp right now?
Jim Goldberg. Thought Shannon Burke was in
all
jail.
All these fucking radio guys can suck a motherfucking dick, in my opinion.
Wow, dude.
That's
controversial. Why are you going to be like
you.
That, though?
Because they're motherfuckers. I could tell you instances where I went into Real Radio to help them set up their YouTube channel, and Jim Colbert fucking said no. No.
No
I was
way.
Talking to Russ Rollins about helping them set up a YouTube channel. Anyway, these guys are all fucking scumbags. That's all. That's all. They pretend to be.
Wow. Clearly, we just touched a nerve.
No, they fucking pretend to be. But what we're doing here in this room every fucking week is the real deal. We're not making money. We're trying to promote people.
No, no.
Yeah.
Listen, just because you make money doesn't mean it's the real deal either, by the way. If I may just inject that little thought into this whole discussion, just because you make money at something doesn't necessarily mean it's not the real deal.
Oh, well.
A lot of people do sell out. That is not wrong.
Whatever, you know,
just don't dismiss me like that. Don't belittle me like that.
I don't know. I don't fucking care anymore. It's season apocalypse. Fuck everybody. There you go. Fuck you. You don't want to call into the show? I mean, I'm kind of pissed about this. I got the first hour and a half, and we don't record this shit. Fucking pieces of shit. We do everything live, right?
Yeah.
So now these
fuck
fuckers
it, we'll
are,
do it live. Fuck it, we'll do it live.
They're not, you know. So now nobody's calling in. Oh, we're gonna get a little story. Oh, I'm so sorry. I'm just tired of that shit in life.
Well, did you text them? Do you like, hey, we're good?
I've already messaged. I've already done what
back,
I'm gonna do.
Nothing back.
It's a fucking it's a game to people out there. They can go fuck themselves.
That's not okay.
All right. Well, it's not a game to me, but I'm gonna take off. You know, I'm not here to shit talk anybody. And it sucks that that's what it's coming to. So,
see you later.
All right.
All right, buddy. See you later. There you go. Let's go to a song appropriately titled Fools by Drug Dealer. The JB Rev Show, or maybe it's just the JB Web Show now. I don't know. There.
What just happened?
Life on a thin line, but it really gets you down. You can try, but it don't feel right. Oh, to light a candle for the underground. It's not the same song you remember. Yeah. not the same song you remember. You can try, but it's just plain wrong.
Welcome back. I am JB Webb. Bringing up my microphone for a specific reason. You know, that was a little dramatic of me. I am normally don't have that disposition. I'm normally not a hateful person. So if you're listening to that first segment there, I sincerely apologize to you, man. You know, I normally, you know, hold a lot of stuff back. I feel like I've been through a lot here in Orlando, and I don't feel like I've always gotten a fair shake where I should have several times, because my goal has always been to be on radio. I love radio. So when I realized that goal couldn't come into being, I kind of, you know, got a little bit bitter and, you know, just said, hey, I'm so glad I'm able to do this show and help promote people. So when not only, you know, let's say an hour or two before the time, I get, you know, the message from Beth, she can't come. She was sick. That's what she says, right? So that's okay, you know, but the Katie McKinley not calling in at 7:30 really set me off. So I just want to apologize to everyone. I don't think you're all dicks, whoever I called a dick in that tirade. So I do apologize. I love radio, and I feel like, you know, nobody's ever really seen what our potential is here. You know, in 2010, I started interviewing people, just like everyday people, you know, and promoting Will's Pub. That was the first episode with somebody who wrote a book, Beth Ziegler.
So are we on the air? People
we are
saying we're cut off.
Oh, it says you that we're it? On the air.
Okay.
Who's saying we're cut off?
Oh. Several people.
Oh, well, maybe. Yeah, there you go. Maybe we got shadow banned.
Okay. Shadow banned.
Yeah, we talked about banned. Shadow banning. Anyway, so point being, you know, when you're trying to do something pure and you get kind of, you know, knocked down, or you run into all these obstacles and you overcome them only to not get any kind of recognition for, you know, the body of work. Now, I'll be the first to admit, you know, sometimes I do things hastily and misspell words, or, you know, make mistakes in videos or audio or whatever, or something like that. But the point at the end of the day is that, you know, I spend a lot of money to make sure I got all the equipment, all the infrastructure, all the technology. We go out to local businesses and promote them. And, you know, there's so much that we've done in this town first, and other people are now doing, and they're the trailblazers. So it just kind of bothers me to a degree that Orlando hasn't really given us the love that we put out. So that's all that was. Putting out love, not feeling the love back. All right, so I apologize. So we don't have a call at 7:30. I hope we've still got Austin Vanderbleek at 8:30. I asked him if he could call in a little bit earlier, but I have no idea if he's going to be able to do it. Now, listen, it's really not the time. I know. You want to go on a rant now? All right, bag. Okay. Wow, that was...
Rabbit, your favorite guest. The bag.
Who's S and a D? Oh, my God. Anyway, all right. Well, back to whatever we're doing.
I got nothing.
You know...
You got nothing.
I got nothing, but I do want to comment.
You had that apology, though.
Right? I did have that apology.
Good.
That was just out there. But I did get to see the pictures of your Yacht Rock brunch, which looked fun as hell.
Well, dude, let me tell you something.
Yeah.
It was a lot of fun.
Yeah.
And that's really everything I try to do every moment of my life is have a really fun. Good time.
Mm-hmm. You were dressed as Elton John, yeah?
I was, yes, Sir Elton John.
It was an excellent outfit.
The best part of that outfit was the fake penis.
So let me finish up here. So, listen, life is fucking short.
Yeah.
And I don't have time for drama. And I won't put up with drama, you know? And, like, I'm all about having a good time all the time. And that's why I do this with you. And if we're not having a good time, I've got nothing to do with it.
You know what I'm saying? I really like that. I really do. So, you know, you know, our friend Johnny Diggs, right?
Yeah. I love Johnny.
Yeah. So I started playing music with him, right? And he had played music at Howl at the Moon and stuff like that. But I just started playing, guitar with him. And part of what... And, you know, and we only play it like little indies, not only, but we play it like Maxine's and little indies and some other.
Where are you
places.
Going with this?
I was just saying, anyway, sorry. I was just going that, you know, there are some great musicians here in Orlando, right? And, you know, it was him and I on a piano and a keyboard and, you know, we're not the greatest, but we have fun out there playing together. Right? Uh-huh. And doing our little thing, and he's got his little stick, you know, with all his, like, you know, lounge dig as music, and it's fun, and we have fun, and we involve the audience, and, you know, so, like, I don't know, I was just kind of trying to relate to, like, what you're saying, like, if you're just going out there and you're actually having fun together,
right,
then hopefully everyone else will be having fun, and that was, like, what we tried to do, is, like, we felt like if him and I were having fun playing music and enjoying ourselves, and giving off that vibe that we were just like having a good time, then everyone else tend to have a good time as well.
Well, what a classy guy. Well, the whole show is dedicated to Austin Vanderbleek down south. You may have met him at the Freddie Knuckles thing. Mm-hmm. Remember when? Do you remember that? It was like...
I want to know more about this Freddie Knuckles thing.
Yeah. You don't know who Freddie Knuckles is? There was... Hello?
I mean, Freddie Knuckles to me sounds like, you know, somebody's going to come break my kneecaps.
No.
If I don't pay back my loan to, you know,
Freddie Knuckles is
to the big boss,
an American DJ, Francis Warren Jr., better known as Frankie Knuckles, was an American DJ, record producer, and remixer. He played an important role in developing and popularizing house music in Chicago during the 1980s when the genre was in its infancy.
Oh, really? That's pretty cool.
Yeah. So he's a big Frankie. So I believe he has passed away. Is that right? No. Yeah, 14.
Frankie Knuckles.
There he is.
Has passed away.
He died March 31st, 2014. So what they did in 2014, I think, was a tribute. Now, Mills area, remember where they had the Mills Gallery by, I forget. I got the phone Bluetooth in. I'm sorry. Okay, you found a way around. Good job. Hold on. What's that? What?
Link is Bluetooth in.
Sometimes I don't listen to some of our podcasts.
Uh-huh.
Awesome.
Yeah. That doesn't... That sounds a little plastic.
Yeah, it does.
Anyway, the point of that, I don't know if you went to that. You know where they redesigned the Mills area with Fresh Market?
Awkward.
Yeah.
And all that.
Yeah.
You know, that
my
was
life is awkward.
So, yeah.
Let me tell you, and this is why, like, you know, before I came here today, tonight, I went to the New Standard. I saw my friend. No, it's the New Standard, which is where the Ale House is, Lee Road. Former Dexter's owners.
Okay.
I went with a good friend of mine, Linda Sullivan, and of course my beautiful bride. Yeah. And my friend Stephen Rock is the manager there now.
Oh.
And
he's a talented musician.
Yes, he's he's a very talented manager as well. And, you know, me and Stephen have a rich history because I actually hired him to come in and wait tables. The first time he ever waited tables was for me at Nona with Kevin Fonzo. And then he ended up having a career with Kevin. And then Ravenous Pig, he was the manager there for a while. And now he's the manager at New Standard. So I went to go see him. And then Thomas Wynn is doing all the bookings there. So, really? You know, yeah.
That's cool.
So I kind of had to leave there early.
Yeah.
But then I had to go meet up with Jennifer Payne
right.
to get this anniversary present for Dana.
You should post a picture of that.
I will.
No,
that is amazing.
It's watercolor, right?
Or no, that's oil.
Charcoal. Oh,
that's and it's
wow.
It's amazing.
But there's no glass. You got to get that. Like, should you put it behind glass, or are you going to leave it like that?
I don't know.
It's awesome. It's a beautiful frame.
That's how it came from.
Yeah.
Her husband made the frame. And then, of course, she did the painting.
Yeah.
And, you know, and I had to leave early. We went to Nora's, and it was a surprise there. Had to leave early there to, you know, come here. And then I come into your fiasco.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, you know, I was having a great time.
I'm so sorry.
Fucking good time with my bride.
I'm so sorry.
And, you know,
yeah.
And I cut that shit to come here. And right. I'm like, you know, the fuck am I doing?
It's season apocalypse, man.
Yeah, well, you know.
Everything's horrible.
Might be properly attired. I don't know.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Know.
But hey, man.
Well, I mean,
life is too short for the bullshit.
Two guests
and
back to back that I promoted.
What's that got to do with me?
I paid to promote them heavily. I got a lot of skin. He was genuinely upset.
You know what I mean?
That happens. I got all the skin.
If we're gonna start again, I'll just walk out again.
I got all the skin.
Well, I'm not
it's,
sorry.
It's all good. Listen, I'm just telling you both, or you especially, JP, Jack DeMarco. You're fine.
That's a strange turn of events.
Well, because I'm directing it to you. I mean, yes. This is really, Jack doesn't have anything to do with it.
Yes.
You know, the reason I agreed to do this with you was to promote talented, awesome people.
Yeah.
Not to put anybody down,
well,
no matter how
bullshit. Well, this is the first time I've ever done it, my man.
That's fine. In 10 years.
So, yeah, I thank you for forgiving me. I hope people out there forgive me.
Well, you know,
Because it's not my character.
Because I know you. And I know you're a good person.
Well, it's not my character. I'm just kind of fed up. I a lot of personal stuff going on in my life where people I trusted deceived me.
Leave it at the door.
And, okay.
I know, but we're in your door.
Very complicated, yeah.
Yeah,
so my home studio, so very hard to leave it at home.
Gotcha. Yeah. Well, hey.
Anyway.
I love you, bro.
Good Juju is the name of this edition,
that's
ironically.
All right. Good Juju.
So, there you go.
That is the name of it.
Good Juju / Season Apocalypse.
So
the contradiction is.
I just want you to know.
There we are.
You know, I left really good times to come here into this, and that's why I'm like, what the fuck am I doing? You know?
I mean, I hear you.
The whole reason I do this
is
to have a good time.
You witnessed it live like I did.
No, I know. I was right here. Thanks for bringing that up, Jack. Captain Obvious over there.
Yeah.
I mean, sometimes I just need to talk to make the awkward even more awkward.
You know what I mean?
Hey, pull my YouTube or my Bluetooth up.
You know what I'm saying, though? Like, make the awkward more awkward by just
keep talking.
Turn
your phone off and mine will automatically come on.
No,
it
you got to actually connect it. The control is over here in the board.
Yeah, I know.
Believe me, I know.
All right, we'll just try it.
I have to disconnect myself and connect you.
Actually, if you disconnect yourself,
uh-huh.
This will automatically pick up. I know how Bluetooth goes too. Just try it. Just disconnect your phone. How's that? Don't do anything with the main panel. Just disconnect your Bluetooth on your phone. Oh, you already did on the panel. No.
I'm unpairing it on the board. There you go.
You don't have to do all that.
Okay. Yeah, I do. Because right. I have to initiate it from the board. This is a professional mixer.
Well, mine's. Yeah, I know.
So do you see it?
I got a professional.
All right, let's see. See if he can do it. Put your pairing on. Now you need me to initiate.
Well, like, I mean, if you...
you said I didn't need to do that. Okay. I've initiated it, sir. So you just look for it.
Connected.
Is he working? He's doing it.
Let's see.
There you go.
The awesome.
Yeah.
There we go, baby.
There you go, buddy.
I can use the...
Awesome.
I just want to have a good time. That's why I came here. Have a good time. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I do.
All right. That's why you came, right?
Yeah, I came here to have a good time.
Hell yeah, bro.
Yo. Hold on there.
Oh. Sounds like
Wow. What's going on?
Yeah.
Hey, thanks for joining the call. Hold on. Wait a second.
Awkward.
Hold on. Okay, there we go. All right. I think we got Austin Vanderbleek on the line. It is the JB Rev Show. We're a bunch of mad scientists over here, I'm pretty sure. But, hey, is this Austin? Can you hear us? Mm-hmm. Hold on.
That son of a bitch hung up.
Awesome.
That's it.
Where's your awesome thing?
Awesome.
Okay, thank you. Hold on. Hold on,
awkward.
Austin. Hold on. All right, well, awkward. Can one of you guys say something?
Yeah. Awkward.
Jesus.
Awkward. Awkward. I feel like awkward.
My protector stopped.
The last time, last week when this happened, I went on a rant about how I'd be freaking out if I was in your position
right now.
It
happened again. I know, because this asshole wanted to do Bluetooth. I think we got him on the line. Is this Austin?
Yeah.
Hey, buddy.
Yay.
You're in for it, Austin.
You're the best ever, dude.
Son
of
a bitch.
Thanks so much for calling our show. Sorry about all the melee. I'm not sure if you were listening earlier, but we are definitely excited to have you on, dude. I think I met you a long time ago at the Frankie Knuckles thing. It was in Mills territory there. But do you remember that when you guys did that? I think, was that under Open House Conspiracy?
Yeah, it was. We did a benefit for him. We had, I think, Todd Love. If it was at Sandwich Bar, or was it at Segafredo?
Okay.
The rooftop. Yeah. I don't know.
It was that's right.
We did a few of them. Yeah, just because he meant a lot to me. You know, I never got to meet him, but I did see him the week before he passed away.
Oh, wow.
It was at WMC.
Okay.
I never actually been able to catch him before, but I'd always kind of, anytime there was an interview with him or anything like that, I would, you know, read it or watch it or listen to it, and it always kind of spoke to me and made me feel, you know, better about the path I was on and what I was doing, and less like a black sheep. So,
well, I mean, and that's kind of why I was so happy to have you on the show, dude, because you really do keep the vibe alive of the old school house music. People can go to avbleek.com and check out your website.
What does that spell?
AV Bleek is what it spells.
Okay.
AVBLEKEYKY.
Say it one more time.
Oh, wait. www.aa.
All right, let the guy talk.
All right, go ahead.
It's just because my first name is misspelled, you know, by everyone else's standards.
It's an E, not an I. Yeah,
yeah, Austin with an E, not an I. So I'm not gonna buy my my name, because then everyone will go
misspell it. Yeah,
you know. Yeah, so I was just like, well, two letters before Bleek. That's easy.
Yeah, AV Bleek, and that is what it is. Yeah. AVBleek.com. But Austin, dude, you again. You know, you inspire me because I see what you're doing. You're pushing things forward. Open House Conspiracy is a big effort down south. I know you play a lot of dates. You just got done doing Halloween, right? Silent Disco set, I think.
Yeah, I was at Halloween this weekend. A short little silent.
That's why you sound so tired, right?
Yeah, I'm pretty out of it. I mean, that's like 3 days of camping and being up late.
Yeah, it's rough being outdoors. So give us a little history. Give us a little history about you, man. How did you first get into house music? How did you first start to get interested to become a DJ?
So I've always liked music because I come from the middle of nowhere, Florida. It's unincorporated North Brevard County, so it's like Brevard-Volusia County line. So growing up, I had the internet, and then cows and chickens and pigs, and you know, our neighbors were bull barrel riders or whatever. And my dad like turned our property into like a nursery. So, you know, I wasn't going to hang out with the neighborhood kids or anything, you know, there wasn't any. So I would go to, the internet and just search for music.
Right.
It was always a big part of my life. It's one of the things I've done the longest. And then, you know, you're not really going to get into house or electronic music too heavily that way if you're from the East Coast of Florida, even with the internet. But my parents like New Wave, and so they turned me on to that. And obviously, alternative radio actually around there had stuff like Moby and Prodigy. And so you would hear some of it.
What kind of New Wave music did you grow up listening to?
Like Howard Jones, Tears for Fears, Depeche Mode.
Yeah.
I've heard of them.
Flock of Seagulls. And so. Bunch of stuff like that.
I love the Flock of Seagulls. The Flock of Seagulls is one of my favorite. When they
Flock of Seagulls, they're on the Flock. Yeah, Flock of Seagulls, they're definitely dope.
Oh, I thought it was DJ Flocka with the Seagulls.
But yeah, so I guess house music's more like when I was in college, I was going out to clubs. They still didn't play house music. That was in Tallahassee. But I liked Nightmares on Wax early on, before I knew what house music was, because he was down-tempo, and I didn't know what down-tempo was, but he was. I like old-school hip-hop, and so for me, I was like, oh, these are just more beat makers, right?
Yeah.
Like, I didn't realize that it, like, he had done early techno albums on Warp and stuff like that. But yeah, then I went to London for the summer.
Really?
And then, I was studying abroad and interning at an ad agency there for like 6 months. Or no, for 3 months.
Okay.
This summer, yeah, 3 months. And so I would go out to Ministry of Sound and Fabric, and that's where I actually saw,
Fabric.
Like, oh,
yeah. There's Fabric, dude.
Yeah, there's real clubs and real culture for this music that I always listen to on the internet. Kind of, and you know, and then I came back to Tallahassee and I linked up with this guy, Brad Ashwell.
Brad Ashwell,
and, holding it down there.
I know, yeah, Brad,
and then George St. Pierre, too, who's actually released on the Nightmares on Wax label, Wax On before
Wax On so. And Wax Off was the
right. Talking with Austin Vanderbleek right now, and again, you're definitely down south. St. Pete kind of area. So all right, so take us from where you're at right now to or kind of where you're talking about in the story to where you're at right now.
What you do with that?
Well, so Brad kind of helped me take the electronic influences I got in the UK, because it's still not really an American kind of sound, even though it's big over there. I wasn't going to the right parties for that, and he kind of helped me realize the history of it in Florida. You know, he told me about Oz, and he gave me the rundown about everything. And, you know, at that point I was going to Miami a lot for Winter Music Conference. And I think I'd gone, before going over to London as well, but I just, my taste got a little deeper. And so, yeah. And also, you know, Busto in Tampa,
right.
I would go out to his nights, 'cause I have an uncle that's always lived in Tampa ever since I was growing up. So I just kind of picked up on stuff all around the state, saw what it was like, and kind of saw that there was an element of it that I like, and that also that Brad kind of has always liked and done, because he's been in Tallahassee. He hasn't had to keep up so much with trends of like the statewide electronic music scene. It's kind of its own little bubble and stuff. So I kind of saw that wasn't happening around the state so much, like the New York, Detroit, Chicago kind of old school stuff, but not people that were stuck in the old school. They were still, you know, with their finger on the pulse. It was just a little different sound. It wasn't as ravey. It was more soulful.
Yeah, a lot of soul. So, like the Miguel Miggs, you know, Naked Music kind of stuff.
Naked Music. Yeah.
No, well, they really had a great jazzy, housey vibe, right? And that's the kind of sound that I dig. I love Q Burns, you know. I love people that take chances. Q Burns.
Q-Bert.
Q-Bam.
The Game is my favorite.
Oh, Q-Bert.
Q-Bert.
He's talking about Q-Bert, that little... All right.
Love that guy.
Yeah, he's talking about the hip-hop guy.
Yeah. No, he's talking about the video game character.
The video game from the 80s.
Oh. Yeah.
That little weird thing with a little weird nose, and he would, like, jump up that pyramid. Bloop, bloop, bloop.
Oh, yeah, I know that. No, but actually, going back to
Q-Bert, you don't.
Going back to Q-Burns, when I got out of college, he gave me like a kind of part-time remote job that I was doing while I'm working for 80 promo for a little bit. So that was a kind of like a big help to kind of see another side of the music industry, like sort of the business promotion, PR. And just in general, I mean, that guy, you know, he's such a wealth of information in the industry. And, everyone loves him, too. He's like,
AD
nice
Industries. Yeah, he helps people.
That's what he's doing now.
Yeah, AD Industries. Yeah, he kind of revitalized the brand and everything. Yeah, we spoke with him actually about a year ago, I think it was, during his efforts to do that. But on the line with us now, it is Austin Vanderbleek. And, dude, again, I want to thank you a lot, man. Because
me too, man.
You know,
every
week we seriously try to learn about people and understand, you know, what they're doing. So in saying all of that, you've foraged forward with this open house conspiracy, right?
Forward.
He really has. Yeah, he's kind of like the Infiltrate Celebrate parties here.
Yeah, yeah.
Open house conspiracies
Anarcho?
Like that. Yeah, with that Anarcho.
Okay.
His open house conspiracy parties are pretty broad, and they do a lot of different stuff.
All right. Right
so
on.
So how'd you get involved with that? How did that whole open house conspiracy deal form?
So that goes back to Tallahassee too. So Nick and I, this guy that I studied abroad with in London, who was, he had already DJed some, and I had never DJed, but people had always been like, oh, you know, you should DJ because you like this music so much. And they would come to me for music. So then he was my randomly assigned flatmate when I was studying abroad in London.
Okay.
And him and I were going out all the time. Then we came back from Tallahassee and he was like, yo, there's nothing like what we were experiencing over there here. So let's do some nights together. So him and I did some of our own nights at this place called the Engine Room before it closed. And then it was closing, but we also wanted to do something that was more cross-generational. It wasn't just like us.
What year was this?
And where was that room?
When? Where? What?
So then it was actually
say it again. Hold on. Say start, it was in Tallahassee. Okay.
And when?
Yeah, 2011.
Okay. All right.
So yeah, and we started a night with Brad Ashwell where we did this meeting of like different people from different generations and walks of life, and also different creative fields. There were live musicians. There was DJs. There was dancers.
Right. Right.
And it was a meeting at this place called the Warehouse, which was just a dive bar with a pool hall, and then there's like this back room. And we were doing a meeting and just messing around with some music, and some random townies had walked in, and we were trying to come up with a name for these Thursday night parties that we wanted to do.
Right.
And we weren't having much luck, and I think some different words had been thrown out, like maybe open and house or something, and then one of the townies says something like, you know, it's, you guys feel like you're an open house conspiracy, and like we never saw them again. We don't even know who they are. But we're like,
somebody just said it randomly, and you're like, damn, that's perfect.
That is perfect.
Yeah, well, no, and yeah, so no one can take credit for it either. It's also kind of perfect. You know?
It's in
so
yeah, from the attitude, from the ether. Yeah,
exactly. Yeah. So we did those for about a year before I graduated and left. Okay. And then they lost energy, and then I actually brought it to Orlando.
Yeah.
Because Sandwich Bar. Oh, it's because of Lola. Lola B. Because of her. My friend Jennifer in Tallahassee, who actually was doing an online radio show called Chicago House UK or Chicago.
Okay.
Chicago House FM.
And, okay. Okay. I was gonna say Chicago House UK. That's kind of where is it from? Chicago or UK?
It's in Seminole County. Yeah.
So she was doing that, and she introduced me to Lola when I first came down, and I think I went to one of Lola's nights, and then she let me play for the Queens of Noise, and I was I think the first and only guy to play it. So you know, I mean, like a joke, like I'm their jester.
Well,
you
nailed it in. No, but you did it, dude. And that's cool to hear.
Yeah, and then
Sandwich Bar, right?
Yeah, Sandwich Bar, and then Matt let me do stuff.
Yeah,
he let me do stuff there because he liked what I did, and then we did a few things there. We brought King Britt there with Q-Birds, actually.
Yeah,
with Q-Bird?
That was a really fun
King Britt.
I know with Q-Burns. Yeah. Abstract message.
He's having fun.
I get it.
He's here for fun. No, King Britt. Oh,
I know.
Yeah.
Goddamn King Britt. Q-Bert.
That was my first kind of major booking or whatever. And it was really nice, and it was super intimate. And yeah, it was a great way to start.
I bet.
I really appreciated that.
And then, so you've been DJing for what, like 10 years? Not even, right? Like 9 years?
Like 9 years.
Yeah. So. Dude, that's great, man. You definitely are on the rise. You know, with everything. So Open House Conspiracy then kind of bubbled over. Now you're keeping it active now, right?
Yeah, we're in St. Pete. So I never lived in Orlando. You know, I was
you
in college,
son of a bitch.
Graduated college. Yeah, and then I started doing. I lived on the East Coast again for a little bit right out of college, and so Orlando was the next biggest city. So I would just drive over. You know, it's like an hour drive from where I lived.
Right,
and do the nights there. But that was a little taxing because, you know, people didn't understand that I can't go to everything and be supportive of everything. You know, I'm just out of college and I don't even live in the city. And so also when you don't live in the city, you don't just run into people and say, oh, by the way, I'm doing my night again. So I feel like we never have
A little disconnected
success. Yeah, as we could have had. And then I moved from Sandwich Bar to Vinyl Arts Bar at some point. We did nights there. We had Mystic Bill. We had King Britt again.
Yeah.
We had Roy Davis Jr. there.
And let's talk about Vinyl Arts Bar because, you know, Our boy over there is, we love him.
Yep.
Hold on. It's on the tip of my tongue. He's got a cool name.
Wilson.
Wilson. There you go. I always, when I say he's got a cool name, I always, think of him on a stranded island with, Tom Hanks.
Yeah.
How did I know you were going to go there? I'm like, so glad we're on the same page. That's,
I knew
it's in the script. It's a, this is all scripted. I would remember the whole show.
His name.
You know, some people say all our lives are scripted. We've already made the decision.
This is all assimilation for sure. I mean, Bob Leamy is right now fucking putting glory holes in truck stops in Panama City. Fucking, and he's got the biggest drill bit. I mean, dude, it's a custom-sized drill bit that just not anybody can get. So he's a busy guy because it's just the right size. You know what I'm saying? Anyways, back to you.
Sorry, Austin.
I got lost.
Yeah,
sorry. Yeah, I got lost.
We all got lost there for a second.
That was the reverend.
It was a bit of a tangent.
Anyway. So, yeah, so you were at the point where you're like, hey, you couldn't really take off in Orlando, you know, because of the distance.
Also, well, not just that. I moved from the East Coast over to St. Pete in Tampa because I, you know, got an advertising job. And so then, okay. You know, when I was over here, I actually wasn't doing parties over here because I was just feeling out the scene in this area. And I was still doing my residency in Orlando. So still, now it was like an hour and a half drive instead of. Right. Or like almost 2 hours sometimes if it's St. Pete.
Keep listening, Bob.
And then eventually I stopped Orlando because, you know, it just didn't make enough sense anymore. And then we started up in St. Pete. And but it was nice to have that time to like wait until it was right and ready. And I found a location I liked. And St. Pete, we went back to our like pop-up roots, warehouse roots. And
there's no better place to pop up than in St. Pete.
Yeah, I mean, St. Pete.
And the beach?
Yeah, it's insane over there.
That beach. Dude, all the murals going on over there.
Yeah, like old school, like pop-up rave style, right? Is that what you're talking about?
It used to.
Like just pop up in warehouses.
I was talking about penises.
No, I know what you were talking about. I was talking about popping up warehouse style, like old school rave style.
By the way, I have a correction to make. Bob Leamy is in New York City drilling the fucking.
Oh, those are big. Yeah, you got to make them a little smaller.
He had to take his friend Randy and his wife Michelle and to get custom fitted for the holes.
All right, Reverend. He's never going to share the interview if you keep
ramheading
shit like this into the
session.
But
it's important stuff, dude. He's
glory holes are important things about life.
Dude.
Okay, Austin Vander Bleek on the line.
Bleek.
Let him finish. Let the man finish.
All right, sorry.
Going back to St. Pete, it was known as like a God's waiting room for a while. So,
God's waiting room.
A lot of old people, yeah.
I like how you hung on for that. Yeah. That was good.
Yeah.
That's good stuff.
but the thing is, it's changed so much. Like, it's a little bit cooler and hipper and younger now.
It's way cooler. It's
happening. And even King spoke to it. Like, King Britt came and played for us over here. And we've only done warehouse parties with him. Actually, King Britt chose to celebrate his legacy tour, like over 30 years in the music industry with us in the warehouse in St. Pete. He was basically like saying, you know, I had told him about it being God's waiting room. He was like, it's really nice there. Like, he likes it. And he's like, you know, it's interesting what people have done there to inject it with energy and art. And so.
Right. Yeah.
It's a great city. I mean,
It's a great area, and King Britt is fucking
dope. The Salvador Dali Museum's there, man.
The fact that this dude has connections, you know, with people in and around Orlando, you know, he's paying his dues right now, and that's why I wanted to have him on, because he's under-recognized.
Yeah.
He does fucking...
Make it happen.
Yeah, he spins... he plays some badass shit.
9 years strong, bro. That's fucking killer. He's like, you know...
Yeah.
For real.
I'm under-recognized, maybe... For, you know, like I can always be doing more. I mean, this is all I do for a living now is DJ.
Yeah,
but also, awesome. I've always, you know,
that's all you're doing.
Really about the it's not really about the recognition though. It's about, like he said, the connections or whatever. Like to have Michael Donaldson, you know, be a colleague on. You know,
oh, Q-Burn, you called him out by name
for him.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, Q-Burn's our to have him, you know. Kind of give a thumbs up to what you do and help you and want to support you, or to have Michael Zucker, who's also from Orlando and runs a label that's like internationally renowned, and is, you know, it's a vinyl, it was vinyl only label that was exported everywhere. You could do label showcases at some of the most top clubs called Finale Sessions. You know, he would always support me, and Manny Cuevas, who used to do a radio show in Orlando a long time ago, DJ M-Trax, one of like the first people playing house in Florida. He would support me. So for me, that was the kind of
DJ M-Trax
that.
See, I didn't know
M-Track.
That. Oh, M-Track. Okay.
M-Track.
Do you know? Well, that's why I was like, what
well,
the
yeah,
fuck?
Yeah, I know M-Track.
You know M-Track? Okay. The Reverend's a great aficionado of not only, you know, and the Reverend got his name from DJ Icy, technically. Yeah. So you got good company here in the room. But Austin, go ahead with that. Sorry about that.
Well, so that was kind of the thing that fulfilled me was that was more validation than like large numbers of people or whatever.
You're in good company.
And also I'm coming up in the EDM time. So it's actually like if a large number of people are paying attention to me, that means I've gone some route.
Yeah,
that,
you know, you're not doing something. You're doing something to sell out.
Yeah, it has kind of sucked for me because I don't have a ton of peers. Like I was always partying with like 40 something year olds, even, you know, 50 plus, and you know, like I never had like young kids that I was partying with in their 20s when I was in my 20s. You know, I'm 29 now, but and you know, especially not these
he's
days.
So young,
like,
yeah, you're so young.
My age. So yeah. It was always that was a little tough for me because I feel like I missed out on being, you know, kind of dumb and. You know, like partying a certain way.
Yeah. Oh, there's plenty of time for that, bro.
Yeah, when I was 29, I was not trying to get my groove on.
And there's plenty of time for you to be dumb and still party.
Yeah, build a name and everything.
Yeah.
So you got the Austin Vanderbleek.
I'm 46 years old.
Right?
I do dumb party things all
the
time.
Dumb party tricks. That's Jack McDemarco.
Yeah.
He's.
I just mean I was partying in like already a very mature way of like like you guys know how to party like. You know, it's like you still party hard, but you do it in a way where, it's like stupid stuff, super stupid stuff doesn't fly. You know
yeah,
I mean? Like,
yeah, dude.
Know,
it's called partying responsibly. Stories. It's called doing games.
So listen, I got a question coming up online here from actually from Bob Leamy.
Oh, really?
He's actually correct me. He's not in NYC. He's in North Carolina. He's in a Fayetteville truck stop.
Okay, you said
and
you had a question.
I do. He's got a question for Vanderbleek.
Oh, okay.
He actually stopped drilling a hole for this question. He wants to know what artists inspired you and to create some of the stuff that you do. Thank you, Bob.
So, like I said. One of my mentors and influences, Brad Ashwell in Tallahassee, helped direct me a lot.
No, he was talking about like musical artists that like, you know.
Is it David Bowie? You know, maybe somebody.
Well, no. Okay. Don't put things in his head.
But don't put things.
Yeah, no. It's like putting things in Bob Leamy's glory holes other than your cock.
Like Nightmares on Wax is like a really big influence for me. I mean, there's this guy from Atlanta.
Right.
He's from Detroit.
Nightmares on Wax.
His name's Kai Alsay. Yeah. I go every year to Atlanta.
Right,
to
right.
Hear him play every Labor Day weekend for House in the Park.
Yeah,
kind of
wow.
Like it's like the Chosen Few picnic in Chicago, or right. Some of the house parties they do in New York. They do like these parties in the park that are free, and you can take your family. And so I've been going every year to see him play, and he's really influenced me a lot. And he's a producer too, and he's actually just now kind of getting. A few years ago, he like really got his production legs under him, where everything was like studio musicians and like just really quality. And so he's been blowing up a lot too. So he really inspires me. And I've always loved Carrie Chandler's house music. You know, and then
what about any of the Chicago DJs like Bobby D or Tim Spinnings or Mickey Oliver
For me, Chicago, it's like Roy Davis Jr.
Right.
We actually have a Chicago guy this Saturday. His name is DJ Skull.
Right.
And he's like a harder Chicago sound.
Yeah, that's new school. I'm talking old school, you know, where sound.
No, Skull's old school. Skull was like shopping his records around to Trax Records at the age of 15 in Chicago in like 85. And he moved on to the
right
music
on.
Box and the power plant. And so he's old school, but he just always got bigger in Europe because Miss Jax from Jax Beats and Jax Upbeats put him on. So
Right,
like,
right.
He's a Chicago guy that sounds like Detroit. And then, you know, Roy's pretty early Chicago guy.
Let me ask you.
Roy Davis Jr.
Let me ask you. Are you familiar with who Mickey Oliver is?
I don't think I know.
You need to do a little more research. And let me tell you, because that sound, like, you know, it's like Mickey Oliver intensity. Yeah. Just look up. You know what? I'll pull that up so that when we part ways with you, you know, I'll play some Mickey Oliver.
Oh, okay.
But
okay.
Yeah. Okay. Go on.
Early '80s or?
It's mid '80s. Yeah.
Mid '80s.
Yeah.
Wow.
Right when that whole acid house scene was coming about. You know
what
I mean?
We're getting pretty deep on this call. That's good.
That's cool. I'm just, you know, and I want to school him a little bit too. And I've been reading a little bit about you, and I am impressed.
Yeah.
And I really like, you know, where you're going. And you're being as young as you are, you know, don't ever give up, bro. And, like, you know, right now is the time you need to shine.
Yeah.
Because if you don't make it by the time you're 35, you're not gonna make it. You know what I'm saying? Seriously.
Yeah, no, I mean, I feel it a little bit. And actually recently, I mean, I got one of those accolades that is more general. Like, I won the Tampa Bay Best of the Bay.
Right.
Best club DJ or whatever from Creative Loafing just this year. Yeah. I found out while I was in Paris, and you know that feels good in the sense that if I win something like that, I feel like the music won that.
Yeah,
because I'm actually not playing a ton of clubs here. I play more like pop ups or markets or down tempo lounge sets or warehouse things. So it's kind of hopefully what people see from that is, well, you know, we should do more of this music.
Yeah,
in some of the bars and clubs.
It's such a great vibe. Well, you should too reconnect with Matthew Scott, and this is a call out to Matthew Scott for Iron Cow. He's closed. Yeah, Sandwich Bar is closed, and he has opened up Iron Cow. There's a new place called the Nook in. I think they're doing a big sandwich bar night where, anyway, I want to reconnect you with fucking Matthew Scott. Cause
yeah, they do some good things. Iron Cow's a nice little spot.
No, this guy's vibe
in Milk District.
It's so great.
Serve liquor.
It's perfect.
A little bit of food.
It's just laid back.
It's a great
jazzy
spot to do like a great
soulful. I mean, wait till you hear some of his stuff. I was going to play some of his stuff after this, but Rev's got control. Sorry, Austin. Go ahead, bro.
It's fine. The last time I played Orlando was Remix.
Okay.
The record store.
Yeah.
I want to give a shout out to this kid. Oh, okay, cool. Yeah. I played mostly my records. But I want to give a shout out to Christian Vartanarian. I don't even know if I'm saying his last name right, but he goes by December Beaches.
Okay.
He's actually a kid that's from Chicago.
Hmm.
But he goes to school at UCF, and he had me play for him. And he's one of the kids that's always been coming out. And if you like what I do, he's like an even younger version of me. So it's kind of like, you know, I already have that thing where I'm like, oh, there's younger people coming up who, you know, can kind of do similar to what I do or whatever. But I try to, you know, prop them up and, like, help them out where I can and get them to be a part of things. And, but yeah, Christian Vartanarian, December Beaches. He has a DJ Assault coming soon. Like, old school ghetto tracks guy. So
nice.
I don't know if you guys know DJ Assault.
We're big on stylists down right here. On. You know, we're enamored by the breaks down here. But as we're kind of closing out with this whole thing, dude, avbleak.com is the best way for people to get connected to Austin. And, you know, hire him for a gig. Check him out. Look through Open House Conspiracy.
AVBLEEK.
Yeah, you go.
.com.
There you go. Hey. Thank you, Jack. With right the facts. On. Jack with the facts.
So, hey, closing out, where we're going to break into is actually Nightmares on Wax. But I do have a question for you before we leave. Because, you know, now you said they kind of inspired you a little bit. So, you know, all you're doing right now is the DJ thing?
I mean, yeah.
Yeah. So,
that's all he's doing. He's making a living.
So my question to you is, when's your next gig? And where can we see you, and where can people find out more about you?
Well, the website avbleak.com.
Right.
I'm on Facebook, so everything is actually
Twitter.
Avbleak. So
right.
Yeah, it's all avbleak. So
okay. Cool. All right.
If you put the slash and then avbleak for any website, you'll get me on that medium
avbleak.
If I'm on it.
Word.
So. But yeah, this Friday I'm playing North Nightclub in St. Pete. I'm playing records, which is a bunch of other DJs that I think we're all going to just play from our record collection. So that'll be fun.
Nice.
That's a really cool club over here. I don't know if you guys have made it over yet, but it has a minimal kind of European feel with like giant subwoofer system that's like custom by this guy Jason Fetter. Saturday at the Paper Crane Warehouse, we have this guy from Chicago, DJ Skull. Okay.
I heard you say that so before too. That's great.
Yeah, those will be my next two gigs, and then I thought you were going to go ask me about production and stuff.
Well,
question.
Yeah, right. Sorry, next time right. We'll
you're
get into
getting
that.
Into that. You're getting into that though, right? I would imagine.
It's a long story.
Okay. Well, I tell you what. Hey, listen, check this out.
Yeah.
Once you have some music put out there on some, we'll come back to you and we'll play.
He's a maestro.
Play.
No, yeah. I think this guy's a maestro, dude. I think in 10 years you're going to be bigger. It'll be like, holy shit, that guy was on our show. That's what I think about Austin Vanderbleek, our guest tonight. So thank you, brother. You fucking rock. The Reverend's going to bump over to a track.
And hold on with us, okay? Because can he still hold on with us? Okay.
Yeah.
So I'm going to play You Wish by Nightmares on Wax.
There you go. Austin Vanderbleek, thank you, bro. Hang on the line.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Yo, brother.
Time, I'm not having a good time. So why the fuck you listening? Get the fuck off my channel.
That's right. I kind of, you know, it's funny. That's a promo now.
I guess we brought the anxiety. This is our
If you ain't having a good time, I ain't having a good time.
Hashtag good juju edition. So we threw a little bit of hate
for
earlier.
Real.
for people not being able to call us, but people able to call us, and they're actually a little bit of
hate. Everybody, shut the fuck up.
Okay, wait a
second. It's
a
JB Rev show.
Whoa.
That's how we come back. Okay. We do a proper JB Rev show.
JB Rev show. I'm JB.
That was Nightmares on Wax.
There you go.
That was called You Wish.
There you go.
Okay?
All right.
Now, you guys can start blobbering all you want.
I'm excited.
But we got a special guest.
Yeah, I'm excited to announce that one of our
Let me say something before you do.
Scheduled guest now is able to call in. Guess who it is. Hold on.
I want to say that I'm actually really excited because I didn't realize you were bringing her on. And when I first heard her was just last week, and I was really impressed. And I was like, wow, she'd be a great guest. And then all of a sudden it happened. Wow. But I heard her on an afternoon show.
Right.
And
was it
really
on Florida,
out.
Florida Man Radio?
It was on Florida Man, yes.
So we have
happened to hear that.
Katie McKinley.
Yeah.
She's an actress. She is a provocateur. She is a fine example of somebody
who's
not afraid of shit.
She's got a great voice.
And a very good radio personality as well. Welcome to our humble little show over here. How the hell are you doing, Katie?
Well, I thank you very much for the awesome introduction.
Hell yeah.
I appreciate you having me on, and I'm sorry for misunderstanding.
You're here. It's
earlier.
Okay. You're here now.
Let it talk, don't okay? Worry. Stop talking over her, JB.
And I apologize, JB. You know, I didn't even hear what y'all said, so I'm not butthurt about anything.
That's always good to hear. Okay. The Reverend hears that all the time, from what I understand.
Anyway. Well, yeah, the girls that I hang out with, I've heard all their butts.
No, you don't hurt all
damn
their
butts. Damn right I do.
Don't know how words work.
Sometimes I don't have the lube. I got to hurt the butt.
Katie McKinley, so give us a little bit of history about you. Did you grow up around here? Did you move down here? Give us a little
did you
background
go down
there.
Here? Did you, what?
Bing, bing, bing.
I am an actual Floridian.
Awesome.
I grew up and I was born in South Florida.
You are our local legend.
I grew up in Coral Springs.
Okay.
I was born and raised there. That was right next to the Parkland. So people kind of are like, oh, you're from there.
Nice.
But yeah, and I married a guy that was from Davie. So we're two Floridians and... Yeah, no, I've been here all my life. People kind of freak out about hurricanes, and we kind of laugh at them. So,
you know, I like to hear that from someone like you because, you know, between the three of us, I think we're the only ones left because I'm actually a third generation Floridian.
Okay.
So, you know, and there really isn't many of us here that can say that.
Family, like my family, but mostly my in-laws and the other side of my family. No, they go back about like 5-6 generations.
Damn.
Right. So that's
awesome.
That's awesome.
Talking with
awesome.
Katie McKinley of KinkyKatieRadio.com. We always love to learn about people's history. So when you were younger, then you kind of moved up here. How did you get into radio? You know, whatever you want to share with us kind of about the Kinky Katie Radio, because you guys do a lot of risque stuff over there and people can go check that out. You know, it's definitely a mature site and, you know, but give us a little flavor in history. We always love to learn about people and kind of how they came up into doing what they're doing.
Well, I was working at a porn store, like a 3-story porn store in Orlando.
Oh, and Fairvilla?
Yes.
Okay.
Exactly. Fairvilla.
I know. You know okay. I do very well. Actually, the owner is a very good friend of mine. So,
Bill.
Yeah. I know Bill and I know his daughter, Amy. And
absolutely.
I know his wife. Okay. So go on. This is great. I'm loving this.
Oh, my God. A great family. Very nice people.
Yes. Absolutely. So
I like them very much. They've always been very nice and very good to me.
So, hey, Katie, check this out. Let me ask you this. So before it was Fairvilla, were you in Orlando when that used to be a theater?
No, I was not, but I am very aware that it used to be an adult theater. And I'm glad I'm not the cleanup crew because I don't want to clean up other people's.
No. Well, I got to tell you, I actually, when I was 17 years old, I took a girlfriend on a date there to watch a movie.
true
story.
You took a girlfriend on a date.
Yeah,
to a
sure did. And
I
got to tell you that it ended well.
What is wrong with you?
We were young.
That's
where
we
begin.
Full of angst, you know. Anyways, so you were working at Fairvilla. Here in Orlando.
Yes, I was working at Fairvilla. I had one of my fellow employees. She was friends with Shannon Burke's wife.
Oh, Kim. I know Kim, too.
Okay.
Yep.
Yeah. All right.
So she's friends with Kim, and she had a spot on his show way back in the day, about 7 years ago. And then they wanted to give her her own show, and they said, you need a co-host. So she asked me if I would like to do it with her. I said, yeah. And then I started to do the show with her.
Right.
It kind of evolved into becoming my show. And nice. Then I took it from there and went with it.
So are
and
you
that's and, how I'm,
are you and Kim still friends after all this happened?
No.
Oh. I'm sorry. No. All right, then.
Okay.
Well, wait, which one?
Kim.
Not the
Kim Burke.
The current.
No.
Well, I don't know. We weren't really friends to begin with, so we really.
Gotcha.
I mean, I really don't even think she knows who I am.
Right. But, right on. Okay. No worries. Hey.
Well, no, but I mean, no. Know who you are. I've met her a couple. I've met her a couple times, and she was always really nice to me.
Right on.
But I really don't think she even knows who I am.
Cool. Cool. Well, we do. So, and that's why we get you on.
Yeah. We don't. Hey, have you ever heard of shadow banning?
No.
Yeah.
No,
it's
I
a
haven't.
Weird
What's
thing
that?
That goes on. So it goes on out in social media communities, and it'll be like they'll do it to a person or a post.
What?
And they'll just kind of sequester it. So it'll be like anything you post is not really going out to everybody, and it's only going out to you in your little one lane. Anyway, so we were talking about it earlier, but what I want to make a point of that is, you know, we do the opposite of that every week. We really try to talk with people, learn about them, praise them for the work that they do. So we're giving you our humble title of local legend, because you have been 20+ years
true story.
Pumping stuff into the scene. The Reverend doesn't have the music queued up, but that's okay, because you really bring a lot of entertainment to our area here. So we thank you again. So don't worry about the being late and all that stuff.
So yeah,
and I feel extremely honored, and I thank you so much.
You are welcome. You're definitely a local
and
legend.
And I apologize for that before, because it there was a very misunderstanding.
It's all good, because we all learn.
Let's talk a little bit now. Yeah, and we all have, and I have a, you know, you've got to make mistakes and be able to apologize and people accept it. But anyway, and we do. But what I love is your Kinky Katie Radio, dude.
Yeah.
And I don't mean to call
Let's
you dude. Sorry. No, but it's unabashed. I feel like Howard Stern listens to your show. This is like my gut instinct.
I would hope you're,
yeah, that's what
I thought you were saying. You felt like Howard Stern. I'm like, dude, you are so far from Howard Stern right now.
No, shut up over
there. You're
like
a little fanboy over
me.
There.
I'm close to the edge today.
Yeah,
don't push me, cuz I'm close to the edge. Riv,
I know.
Don't push me, Riv.
Katie.
Katie. Your show as well. So let's kinkykatieradio.com. Let's talk a little bit about that.
Sure.
So,
well, what I do is Kinky Katie's World is a show that I do every Saturday night. My husband is my co-host. We call him Mr. SC, and SC is short for stunt cock. Because when I was in porn. When I was in porn, he was the cock in my porn, and it's very large and in charge, and it is a thing to be seen.
Right on.
It's awesome. Oh, yeah, no, it's impressive. And I have no problem with it. And when we have from the beginning, the first hour of the show, we have a pre-show. We take a recent episode, like 2 weeks prior,
right,
and we squirrel it up. We make it sounds like chipmunks, so it sounds like squirreled on purpose.
Wow.
And then we answer questions that I get from fans in between the first half an hour, and then the second half an hour, and then we roll into the live main new episode.
The real thing. So I love it, because it's like a little bit of that radio drama theater, you know, which people don't produce anymore. I wish they produced that stuff. I'd love to be a part of that stuff, but that's why I love it. And then you come in with the live segment, and it sounds really good, you know, and stuff. It's so left to center, it's so out there. So you definitely have to be, you know, free of mind to go to kinkykatieradio.com. I think last week, what are you guys talking about, like trans porn or something like that?
Oh, we talk about pretty much everything from
like,
from trans porn.
What was your topic last week?
What was my topic? We have probably about 13 or 14 topics every time we discuss things. We talked about trans people in modeling jobs. Mm-hmm. We talked about usually a lot of ball torture, a lot of cock torture.
Right.
It's fun. Awkward. And we always have a weekly segment that we call Tits Man, where we mm-hmm. talk about boobs. And tits.
Awesome.
And
men with boob tits. Yeah.
No. Chicks. I love tits. I love boobs. I touch mine all the time, and I throw them out there, and I love them.
Yeah. Well, I'm sure that, yeah.
You got some good cosplay outfits on your Facebook page.
Yeah, she dresses up.
I totally stalked
your
Facebook page.
I'm glad you said that, Jack.
Yeah.
She's also
there's like a leather nun thing happening on your Facebook page that particularly caught my eye.
Oh, yeah, that's not cosplay. That's just kind of a, let's say it's Tuesday.
Yeah, fantastic. Fantastic.
So... That's
tell me
exactly,
more about that.
Yeah, so that's exactly kind of things get a little bit crazy and out of hand. You guys do a lot of role play stuff, all of that.
Yeah.
I like to dress up a lot. That's kind of my thing. I like to try to be sexy. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't.
Right.
But I like to try to be sexy. Sometimes when he comes home, I like to have an outfit on and like elaborate hair and maybe some big old heels or boots on and like, oh, monsieur, you're home so early.
Wow.
Oh, no.
Stunt cock is
and
doing great. Stunt cock has it made.
And yeah, and he's like,
wow.
You know, it's a thing. He's kind of used to it by now because we've been together for a long time. So, he's like, all right, that's enough. Like, what
is it like
do?
A kind of open swinging relationship or what are your kind of boundaries around that?
All I will say is the two of us recently got pineapple tattoos, and that's all I'm going to say about that.
So that's a secret clue out there. I drop it again.
I'm going to Google that right now.
Badass mogul, Maven. No, it's a Maven, yeah. Maven behind KinkyKatieRadio.com, and she is on Florida Man Radio. I think it's Dangerous Conversations.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, you can check her out recently. Go to Facebook. Go ahead, Rev.
All right, thank you. So, Katie, Kinky Katie. Let me tell you something.
Sir.
I have mad respect for you, and the reason that I really like you and what you do is because everything you do is for free. You know, and that's mm-hmm. what we do. We've never made a penny off of what we're doing here. I know you've got things set up that you can, but the reason, I mean, when you're doing something to make money, That's a commerce, you know, it's not an art. That's, you know, and that's why I do this. I'm not doing this to make any money. I'm doing this to promote talented, creative people like yourself and other people here in the community. And that's why I do this show. And it's a pleasure to have people like you on. And, it's really, I wish you nothing but
we had a great show lined up. Things kind of fell apart early.
I was acting
a fool. You surely can.
All right. Thank you. So, you know, it's nice to have talented, creative people like you on, and that's why we do this, you know, and it's really, it's just, I see that your heart is into this and, you know, and that's what it's all about, doing what you love and not doing about, you know, not worrying about what people think.
Yeah.
You know, just doing it. And Katie, that's awesome.
That's what you're doing.
And
that's
you are.
Do it.
That's why
she's a legend, local legend.
That you're...
Do it.
I really appreciate everything that you're doing, too. And I thank you very much. That was very nice of you to say.
Right on, Katie.
Well, the Reverend is always heartfelt. And that's what we try to do. Throw a little love on people. Ask a couple of questions.
That's why I'm doing this.
In doing that, here come a couple of questions.
Then you're going to shit on me.
No,
right?
We're not. Come on. We're not all about that. That's on our shadow band site. You can go to notthejbrevshow.com and find all of our shadow band information over
What's
there.
What's your question?
Anyway,
ask your question.
No, my question is, what kind of things, given how, you know, you've been doing this for a long time, and so have we, and technology has changed immensely in this 10-year span. So I'm talking to you now, you know, leveraging a lot of devices and stuff I didn't have access to in the very beginning.
Devices.
Anyway, so the point of that is, what kind of things do you want to do with your talent that, you know, or check out or talk about or approach with what the style and what you're doing? Are there things that you want to do you haven't done yet? Give us an idea of what maybe, you know, you would love to do
what
down
the future
line.
Holds.
Yeah, what would
what
you love to do
holds,
kind of down the line? How do
such
you feel
a weird
like,
question.
Well, I like
what,
it because it's
question?
Forward thinking. Well, what do you kind of
really
things
not.
Haven't you done
what
that you
want
to do?
In the future? What do you see that's next?
Yeah. Hey, Kitty, what do you
I
think about the
time.
Future?
Hey, Kitty. She's like one at a time.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, no, definitely I would love to move further with my show. Really most of my stuff is uncensored, and hopefully I can find a platform where I can be uncensored and be successful.
Yeah. And I would just love if Howard Stern, if you got on Sirius Radio somehow. I really think that you've got a lot of badass capabilities over there. Well, because you cross a lot of lines. You talk about taboo shit.
I know people on that station, and I would love to be there.
Well, I hope that for you. We hope that for you. And just by talking about it and putting it out in the fucking ether, that's how shit happens. I'm for real. We have important people that listen to our show. We have people with discerning ears that listen to what we do. Anyway, you are definitely a local legend. We appreciate the fact that you were able to give us a little bit of time there. And that's a fucking great answer.
Love you, kid.
I would love to see you go to a serious platform where you can do some more crazy ass hijinks. Go check out our show, Kinky Katie Radio.com. And anything in closing that you'd like to whip out, talk about, strap on, anything?
I want to say, everybody keep doing your thing, whatever you're into. Just because someone else isn't into it doesn't mean that it's wrong. So love what you do. Do what you love.
Do what you love.
With consenting adults.
So
everyone's good.
Perfect.
A question off the internet. Internet.
The Reverend is being sent questions.
So, can you helicopter? Is the question to you, JB?
I hope you're not asking me because I don't have a dick.
Right.
No, I can't do that.
That means like,
I don't think
all
JB
the way
can.
Around.
Yeah,
like 360.
JB can't do nothing.
What the fuck am I, Richard?
I mean, I'm sure I could
Richard
get a
Simmons?
floppy strap on and do the helicopter.
Oh, wow. That would be impressive.
I can't do that personally.
Word.
What would be the point of a limp strap on? Like, I mean, do they even make those?
A
like,
limp
it's not like.
They do.
Really? And
they're
called tackers, and you can
wait,
slap
what?
It on
wait,
someone's
wait, wait,
face
wait,
or you
what,
can do a whole
what,
bunch of stuff with
what?
It.
So it's like a thing.
There you go. I heard something in the background.
He's clapping.
I'm
He's
laughing because
like,
Jack is all of a sudden really interested in this limp dick.
Because like I was like, why? Like the whole point of a dildo would be to like penetrate something, right? So like,
not always.
You know, like the whole point. I guess not always.
It's okay.
I guess not always. So I guess you can really buy a limp helicopter dick for a strap on.
Wow, that's crazy though.
Why we need to talk more often.
You can call us anytime. What are some of the craziest fucking things that you've encountered?
I got lots of kinky shit
with
to
your
talk
show.
About,
I guess
Katie.
In closing,
I was quiet a lot of this interview because,
yeah,
like,
you were.
Well, you know, you guys were doing your thing and talking, and Fair Villa things came up, so I was just respecting it's your show. Like,
okay.
I'm a newbie in season 10.
Yeah, well, that's
10.
Jack DeMarco we have over
but
there.
I got lots to say.
You
so
do
if
have
you
lots
call
to
back,
say about
well, you and I will have lots to talk about. Lots of things to talk about. I added
Katie,
you on friends on Facebook.
Katie,
so,
give us a crazy story.
Back.
Give us a crazy story.
We'll
thank you, Jack. Give us a crazy story in closing.
Oh, gosh. Do you want to hear about the time that I witnessed a guy get completely... I'll tell you the story anyway. I'm not even going to ask you. I'm just going to tell
okay,
it.
That's better.
There you go.
Thank you.
My husband, who was not my husband at the time, but we were dating, we went to a fetish party on New Year's Eve. And we happened to be on some recreational drugs, allegedly.
All right.
Allegedly.
And,
I like that.
And we were kind of hanging out on, I was open-faced, sitting on a speaker box, just having a good old time, watching someone in a cage on the dance floor having a...
What?
Ball. Now, what? We know this guy. He is a South Florida judge.
Oh.
He's a South Florida judge. And he was wearing nothing but a gold lame thong.
This was in South Florida?
Oh, yes.
Okay.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
No, this is not his first time at the club. We all know who he is. Like, you know, just the people who used to go to the parties and go to the parties, we know who he is.
Judge Johnny Brown.
So, tell us more.
Polo.
No.
So he...
Without revealing names, tell us more.
Yeah.
No, I'll tell you more. He was blindfolded and he was restrained and he had a rope tied around his ball sack.
Oh my God.
And the rope that was tied around his ball sack was was strung over the top of the cage. Now on the other side of the cage was this little girl dressed as of age. She was dressed all up and she was tugging on the rope and he was, you know, flinging back and forth against the cage, slamming on the walls, you know, doing a little thing. Well, one of the walls of the cage was the door, and the door was not latched. So when he slammed against the door flew open. He fell to the ground. Well, some things got yoked and removed.
Oh, what? I can only imagine. So his arm, his right arm, completely off his body.
Oh, yeah, sure, his right arm. Okay. I will say that my husband and I were about 3 feet away from witnessing the entire thing.
Did you get blood on you?
And
no, you need to say it. It was his nutsack. No. It was gone.
It was his ball sack. Come on.
It was his nutsack. It was gone.
Gone.
It was all gone. He ran up like he turned around. He kind of looked like he was looking through his underwear that had been ripped off.
Oh,
and he just ran off into the bathroom. No one knew what the hell happened. And there was a string so hanging down from the top of the cage, and it looked like a cat toy or a Christmas ornament hanging there. We didn't know what it was, so we said, "I think something just happened. We need to go check things out." So we got a closer look, and
911.
My husband was kind of the director. He said, "You go find the owner," which I knew. He's like, "I'll go find the bouncers and send another guy to go off and find someone else." And they ended up I found the owner, told him what happened.
Whoa.
He got his truck and pulled it up on the side, which is thankfully it was very close to a hospital.
Yeah.
But they found the guy in the men's room faced against the wall with a wad of paper towels on his crotch.
Right.
Oh.
And there was, and when you had a closer look, you could see the lights. There was dots of blood in the cage and then going off onto where he ran off to.
So let me ask you this.
Note to self, never
Were they able to reattach or
no?
Like, did he die?
Well, he did not die.
He wishes he was dead.
I've seen him since. I was called at my place of business where I used to work by his attorneys.
Okay.
And asked me if I had told anyone about what happened. I said, "Fuck yes, I did." I told every single person that I saw. I'm like, "Oh my God, you don't know what I just saw." So I was like, "Yeah." And I mean, at the time, I think I was on acid.
Oh my God.
So it was even more fun.
Wow.
No, tell more.
Okay. Wow. So that was an incredible story. Very much appreciated. Very graphic and gory. And it's only,
I love it. That's the best kind of story.
That was not what I expected. I was expecting something like kinky and sexual. And that was like, holy nutsacking ripoff, Batman.
Yeah. Thank you. Yeah,
best story ever.
If you wanted sexy and nasty, I mean, I've got a bunch of those too.
Was wonderful. That was
That was a great story. That was not a comparison. That was awesome.
Yeah, we asked for a crazy story, and you definitely deliver. And you do deliver. Florida Man Radio. When are you on there? Is it a weekly bit? I think a weekly segment you have.
Yes, I do 1 p.m. weekly every Tuesday. Awesome. On Dangerous Conversations.
Awesome.
Okay.
Very cool.
And then I happen to know
she
does a live show every Friday. Is that correct?
Yeah. Well, that's with
the
content, and she described that.
It's Saturday. Saturday I do my live show, and that's kinkykatyradio.com.
There you go.
You can get that. It's the pre-show is 9 to 10. The live show is from 10 to 11.
Saturday.
And it is uncensored. And is absolutely filthy.
Yeah.
Word. It is ridiculous and juvenile.
Unbelievable the things that go down on your show.
I don't talk politics. Yep. I don't talk, you know, about serious shit. It's just fun.
It's just all good old fashioned sexual experimentations
and
fun.
Stick 'em.
And yeah, there you go. Rip them and stick them. Katie McKinley on the line. The Reverend's gonna bust over to a track. We adore you. You are definitely a local legend. And we thank you for being on our humble little effort.
Awesome talking to you.
When you listen
here.
Back to this, never mind what I said in the beginning. Just fast forward to your part.
And
just
hold on with this.
Don't listen to what I said earlier. Because I was really pissed. We'll talk on offline about that. But again, you rock. We want to throw people to your site.
I'm glad I didn't hear it.
Yeah. It wasn't just about you.
It wasn't really directed at you.
Everybody in radio, with the exception of Howard Stern.
You may have been the straw that broke the camel's back, but it wasn't directed at you.
And Katie,
it wasn't. Yeah, you were ancillary in the whole thing. Anyway, Katie. But you not calling at the agreed time really was the trigger that set me off. So I want to apologize to you when you listen back to this, because we do love and support people each and every week, and it's no joke.
And I'm telling you though, I swear to God that it was. No. I had a message.
Don't worry,
and I sent it to you.
Hey, misunderstandings happen. Misunderstandings happen. It's all good.
You're awesome. You are definitely a local legend. We thank you so much for being on our show. Thank you.
Aww.
The Reverend's going to run over to a track, but hang on the line with us. It is the JB Rev Show.
That's right. It is. And Katie, just so you know, it was bad enough where I walked out. I was like, you know, but he made amends, and we're glad you're on here.
Thank you.
So this song's going out to you because it's called So Into You.
Oh, damn.
You know what I'm saying?
What the?
Well, thank you so very much for having me. Love you guys.
Thank you. Hang on the line. Katie McKinley, KinkyKatieRadio.com.
JB Rev Show.
But I could not catch your eyes. Now I stand here helplessly, hoping you'll get into me. I am so into you, I can't think of nothing else. I am so into you, nothing else. Thinking how it's gonna be whenever I get you next to me. It's gonna be good, don't you know? From head to toe, gonna love you all over, over and over. Me into you, you into me. But I could not catch your eye. Now I stand here helplessly, yeah, hoping you get into me. I am so into you, I can't get to nothing else. I am so into you, baby, to nothing else. No, no, no. Come on, baby, I'm so into you. I love the things you do. Listen, baby, driving me crazy.
WJBW, Orlando, Florida. The first quasi radio web show.
Wow. Yeah. Hey,
John, welcome to Get Started for you today. Come again?
Wait, what? Hello?
Thank you for calling Papa John. What can we get started for you? Would you like to try our large one-topping pizza for $7.99?
Awkward.
Domino's Houston.
Domino's.
Ours is, it's actually $6.99. It's not Papa John's.
This is Domino's Houston. You're selling a large one-topping pizza for $6.99? Are you f***ing kidding me?
And a 2-liter.
Are you f***ing kidding me? Are you trying to uppercut our prices? Is that what you're f***ing doing? And you called us?
Wait, this is Papa John's?
Fuck you, Domino's. Your pizza tastes like fucking
Papa John's, bro.
I got fired from Domino's. Fuck Domino's. They're not loyal to their fucking customer.
But you couldn't make it. You're a subpar fucking pizza salesman.
Hey, if you're not having a good time, I'm not having a good time. So why the fuck
are
you listening?
Awkward.
Get the fuck off my channel.
And now, breaking news badly.
Breaking news badly. Welcome back, Jack DeMarco.
What's up?
What's up, brother man?
That's been a
great show so far. You guys saw the worst of me and the best of me. Anyway,
wait.
First time I've ever blown up like that. The worst of me was what I did earlier in the show.
Definitely
I feel so
the worst
bad.
I've seen.
Anyway.
But, you know, we all make mistakes. It happens.
I felt it's like Jillicious.
Yeah, there was a heavy Jillicious vibe going on. Anyway, but back. Breaking news,
what's the theme? Juju good?
Jack, good juju.
Juju good?
Supposed to be good juju. Well, that maybe is
juju
a great...
good?
It's a great point that we're not perfect. We're going to make mistakes.
No, we're far from perfect.
We have to be forgiving of each other.
Yeah, sure.
No, we really do. Somebody
for sure.
Some close family member did me wrong this weekend, right?
So maybe you've just been stewing. You got lots
of
stuff.
Let's talk about that.
No, not in depth.
Come
but
on, in depth.
Somebody took something they shouldn't have taken and then lied about taking it. Right? So the point
honesty is always the best policy.
Yeah, the point is sometimes...
Unless you're going
to
lie.
You know, we understand we have to slow down in the world. We have to slow down. We're so used to saying this is fake news. Blah, blah, blah. You've been... Yeah, whatever it is. You've been kind of used to being the Judge Judy executioner, and that's not what we are. We are all fallible. We all make mistakes, and we should all be earnest in everything that we're trying to
fallible.
Do.
Fallible. We're all fallible.
We're all fallible. We're all fucked up.
It's
a news update. We're all fucked up. Thank you.
We're fallible, but we're also fallible.
Okay. All right. English professor. All right. Jack DeMarco taking over the news. Did you ever get my admin invite for the page?
Yeah.
Oh, have you accepted it?
Awesome.
Oh, yeah. All right.
So that's an awkward question right now.
The Breaking News Badly page. I want to tell you a little bit about the page, the Breaking News Badly.
I need to do more work on top of my
Facebook. Hold on. Wait. I'm telling you about the page.
Yeah,
it's
tell me.
Fully automated. So it sends out news articles based on when they appear, and it's an aggregator.
Could I control it?
I've got control.
Can I ghost note? What is it?
Shadow ban?
Shadow ban it?
There you go.
Nice shadow ban.
Can you?
All rise.
All right. Jack DeMarco in the house. Go right ahead, sir.
I mean, so, you know, for this first story here, there's this guy on the internet who was like trolling around talking about how he said that 99% of men could beat a female MMA fighter.
What?
Right?
Awesome.
So, you know, lots of trolling happens back and forth.
Yeah.
And then this fight gets set up between him and Tara LaRosa, who is an MMA fighter and grappler. And of course, she kicks his ass.
Yeah.
Because, you know, dude's trolling on the internet and this girl like fights in a gym and punches people in the face for real. You know, not like dude on a video game. So, you know, so if you want to check that out, you can.
Where's that at? Where'd you get that from?
CavemanCircus.com.
Okay,
CavemanCircus.com.
That's a good source to have. I've never heard of that
super
site.
Super good source.
Okay. Very reputable.
I'm just saying there's video. So if there's video, it's totally real, right? I mean.
Yeah, totally.
Yeah, totally real.
Totally.
He
shoots. He scores.
Choo. And, you know, in Missouri, in the show me state, right? Missouri is the show me state. Show me state.
Show me what?
Show me what?
Yeah, show me glory hole.
A policeman won $19 million in a lawsuit after he was told to tone down his gayness. Yeah. A gay Missouri police sergeant won almost $20 million in damages after being told to tone down his gayness to get a promotion. He was like passed over promotion after a while. And then they were like, why don't you tone down your gayness? And they were like, why don't you give me $19 million so I never have to deal with this anymore. And in China, a 67-year-old woman gave birth.
What?
Yeah, 67 awesome. Years old.
Wow.
That's yeah. awkward.
I mean, that's not awkward. That's Gabe pretty, like, medically wild.
That's not awkward.
67 years old. I mean, menopause typically sets in around, like, you know, 45, 50 for what? 50? I don't know. I'm just making that shit up.
Yeah.
I should probably look that up before I say it. But 67 well, is really old to have a baby.
It is. So it really is. Boy, girl, twins, what? No.
Shit.
Don't got that. But okay. So she had a baby.
I'm reading through.
No worries.
It didn't say.
It's incredible. I think longevity is important, and it's all about what you do.
You know, it's health. You know, if you're just eating health.
Yeah. Here, I got a great one for you, Jack. This is from foodbeast.com. Foodbeast.com. This Hawaiian mushroom makes women orgasm by just smelling it.
That's fantastic.
Now, this article, what year do you think it's from?
2016.
You were very close.
Okay, tell me how close I was.
You want to go?
Don't
over,
leave me fucking hanging.
You want to go up or down? You're very close. You're one away. Do you want to
one
go,
away?
One away. Do you want to go?
What
up
do
or
I
down?
Win if I win?
You
I
win Breaking
correctly.
News Medley. You win your own show here. That's
so. What
that's
did I say? 2016. I don't even know what I said. I say 2017 for the win, Pat. I'm going to say 2015 for the win.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
You are right and
2000
wrong.
Right and wrong.
You won. Everything and nothing. Oh, the bag. Bag is back.
Oh, okay. I forgot the bag was here. Yeah,
it's very quiet. There's the whole Kate. Oh, yeah, the Kate. Katie, Kinky Katie.
Thank is God that, the bag was quiet for Kinky
he
Katie.
He said Katie Kinky.
How are yeah. you, bag? Good.
He's used to getting stuff put inside of him. What? Sometimes very forcibly. Oh, my God. Is really? This a confession? This is not a confessional. That you're tired of people just putting stuff inside of you. Okay. I agree. I understand. I know what it's like. Anyway. All right. Here we are on Breaking News Badly. The Reverend, are you out of here, buddy?
I'm out of here, buddy.
All right, buddy. Good seeing you. Thank
I
you.
Got you.
Get the fuck out of here. Be safe.
Yes. I got a couple more if you
got we any, got some more Breaking News
I mean,
Badly.
Unless you want some, unless you got anything special happening.
No, I got some more stuff.
I mean, you know, a woman in Kentucky.
Yeah.
Shot up a KFC.
What?
In the drive through.
How dare you?
You know why?
Why?
Because she wasn't given her fork and napkin with her meal.
Where?
So.
Kentucky Fried Chicken in Kentucky? Yeah. Is that what you said?
Investigators were dispatched to Shelby County on Monday. Right. The witness, yeah, the woman was going through the drive through. She wasn't given her napkin and her fork. Yeah, there's pictures of the shot up drive through.
Wow.
So you know, guns are good. Let's keep giving them to people. Mm-hmm. You know, yeah. That's how I'm breaking news badly tonight. Like, let's keep giving guns to people because
fuck those motherfuckers.
You know, because hey, I didn't get my napkin or my fork, so I'm going to use my Second Amendment right to shoot the fucking place up.
Wow, that's scary, yeah. Jack. I mean, don't talk like that.
I mean,
I guess
essentially
it.
What that story says. Am I wrong? Essentially that's what that story says.
Yeah.
You could brush it over, but like this woman who has a right to have a gun just shot up a KFC because she didn't get a napkin and a fork.
Ridiculous. It really is. Anyway, sorry about that. I thought I had something queued up, but I didn't.
Oh, but I got sandbagged. You sandbagged me.
Is that what I did? Oh, but you were on a roll there, me. And it is horrible to do that. I was gonna play a couple minutes of Trump here.
Hold on, please.
You want this? Hold on.
Is he getting booed? Is
it? Look at the size of that guy.
I can't stand
his
voice.
He's a massive guy. This big, powerful guy. This guy is. He is a monster, a giant of a man.
One really large person.
I've seen a lot of people over the years. Big people.
You know, I have a friend, big guy, one of the biggest in the world.
One of the biggest.
Big, strong friend of mine. He weighed like 250 then, which 250 then is big. That's like 310 now, right? This was a long time ago.
It's a lot of big people I'm standing next to. That's some big people behind me.
What?
So this is a like 2 minute clip of him just talking about big men. It's weird. It's like, what?
Maybe he's got a cuckold issue.
I don't understand.
Maybe he wants to wank some big understand. Men.
Yeah. When somebody can put together something like this in the span of a few years, it's like he's basically saying the same thing over and over and over again.
I can't talk about Trump right now.
All right.
He's
well,
like,
anyway,
he's out of control.
That was my video clip I had. Here's another quick one. All right, so Crime After Crime is a parody song. It's really good. All right, there you go.
Sexual harassment, like grabbing.
That's fantastic.
All right, so there you go. We should share that. Yeah, we should share that on the page. All right, there you go. Share that out there. Anyway, okay, Jack, you got a couple more?
Not really. I'm about done.
Y'all done?
I'm about done.
I want to show some outrage here. Let me play another clip.
Oh, because you weren't fucking outraged enough tonight?
Right.
Do it then.
Oh, I took my
you got
away.
Like silent all of a sudden.
Yeah, sorry about that. I took my feed away.
Anyway, noise was magically going to happen. Oh, it magically happens because I'm here, God. Just keep talking.
Russia, if you're listening, I hope you're able to find the 30,000 emails.
Russia, if China, if someone else offers you information upon you, should they accept it or should they go away?
I think you might want to listen.
China, because they don't know what's happening. Into the Biden.
And I'm from the pits of nigger hell, and I know what's happening. If you won't listen to me when I make an appeal for the Negroes, because you have no concern for the Negroes, listen to me when I make an appeal for America.
Yeah.
You claim you love America. We love America. But you are driving us back and you are making a Samson out of us, and we are going to pull down the pillar.
Yeah.
Should you try to pretend that I'm crazy? Because I want America to be saved. Riots that goes on in this country, in any city. The city is better than Pittsburgh. And then you think we have no right to ask for something? Is it too much to ask you to grant us human dignity? Should we be put down and shot to death for this request? If so, you can aim your guns. What the hell do you think we care about dying if you're going to deny us the right to live?
All right. That's a little bit of breaking news badly. Little fucking jagged episode. That was a man from 1968 speaking out in Pittsburgh.
I mean, America, dude.
He is fucking right. We need that spirit now today more than fucking ever. So I apologize. I kind of lost my cool, but I've never done that. And I feel that I have I was the most authentic me I've ever had. I fucked up and I admitted it. You know what? I'm sorry. I don't think all those people are dicks. You know what? But I do think that what we do over here is very unique and very special and very important. So if you don't place the same importance upon somebody spending time, energy, and money each week to promote people that are underpromoted, that are talented, then it's exactly why we I find an issue with that. I don't want to be fake to anybody ever. So
fake's not good.
Fake is not good. Too much real might not be good either. Right?
Too much real.
No, right.
Sometimes it might not be good, but you know what? Being real is good.
It is good. Anyway, you know, Jack, I appreciate you, Reverend. We love you.
Rev.
People out there, awesome. Thank you. Katie McKinley.
Katie,
thank you.
Awesome.
Austin Vanderbleek. Austin. That dude was really interesting.
Yeah,
dude, the Rev, great story. We got to go pretty deep.
Yeah, you got, Rev had some knowledge, man. Those guys got one back deep.
There you go. So let's do a little sponsor crawl, and we'll get the hell out of here. Thanks, guys, for listening. Thanks for realizing we're fucking humans. I mean, I don't know. Make mistakes. I mean, nobody's perfect. Whatever. Anyway.
How dare you? I am perfect.
Oh, you are. Okay. Here we go. See you next week. Oh, no, we're off next week. Bye.
We want to thank PocasHottest.com, ShannonHoltArt.com, OrangeBlossomBrewing.com, Etoileboutique.com, BadassSandwiches.com, Infotainment.com, Kush Ultra Lounge, Dank Orlando City Smoke Shop, Orlando Art Army, Iron Cafe, Iron Cow Cafe, thank you, Kathmandu Winter Park, GroundingRoots.com, EarTheater.us, DJS.com, Nora's Wine Cigars.com, LittleIndies.org, and RemixRecordShop.com. Thank you so much. Season 10 of the JB Rev Show keeps rocking. That's how we do it. Your local businesses are awesome. Thank you.
WJBW, Orlando, Florida. The first quasi-radio web show.
Wow. Yeah.